Brian Burke has been a player agent, a big shot executive for 5 NHL teams, a lawyer. The list goes on, and it actually includes a time where he was the Rolling Stones security guard. Well, kind of.
As the smallest guy there, they hired the University of Minnesota football team. They told us to wear a tight white t-shirt and blue jeans, so we looked ripped, and I thought I looked pretty good. And the guy said, the guy next to me was like 240, and the guy beside him was like 260. And the guy said, you're too small. You can't stand in front of the stage. You do the stage tour. So I got to meet them all.
This is just one of dozens of stories Brian shared in his new book, Burke's Law, that is out now. It's not all hockey stories, but it does give you an inside look at what the league used to be like. During his tenure as the NHL's Director of Player Safety, a department that is now made up of over a dozen people that have access to quick video replay. But when he was in charge, they had 4 VCRs that they had to rely on, and sometimes it didn't even tape the entire game.
So we would have Glenn Adamo from our broadcast department, was the only guy who knew how to program the VCRs. He would come down, ask me which games I wanted. So if puck drop was at 7:10, we would start the VCR at 7:20. So then if it went into overtime, sometimes we wouldn't get the overtime. Like if a Zamboni broke down or a piece of glass broke and there was a long delay, we never got the end of the game.
Burke dedicates an entire chapter of his book to his late son, Brendan, who died in a car accident in 2010. Just the year before he died, Brendan, who was involved in hockey, publicly declared that he was gay. Brendan and Brian marched together in the Pride Parade in Toronto that year and advocated on trying to make sports, especially hockey, more inclusive. After Brendan's death, Brian and his son Patrick created the platform You Can Play, which is a social activism campaign dedicated to the eradication of homophobia in sports.
LGBTQ people won't be equals of straight people in my lifetime. I'm smarter than that. It's going to take a long time. And we're facing a bit of a setback in parts of the country and south of the border. And so to me, we got to keep the battle going. We got to keep fighting this fight. But just we should never lose sight of how much progress we've made. I march in pride parades. I long for the day when there's no pride parades. Because there should come a day when we don't have to celebrate one part of the community over another. So I hope if we're doing pride parades, it's because we're just celebrating that we've come so far.
Burke admits there was a time, though, when the hateful comments towards the LGBTQ community used to infuriate him.
I used to get mad, and now I focus on we are so far ahead of where we were 10 years ago, and we'll be so far ahead in 10 more years. Don't let a handful of idiots wreck that progress or deter us.
Lindsay Dunn, City News, Toronto.